thank you so much for coming to the concert. Really appreciate you all for joining us for some wonderful music this evening. I thought we'll take this opportunity to introduce this instrument, viol, to everybody here. What you just saw that I play was the bass viol, the lower family, the lowest voice of that same instrument. And this is the treble viol. There's also one tenor viol and alto viol that's being frequently played. The viol family instruments originated early back, and particularly being used a lot in Renaissance period and all the way to late Baroque period. It started to be six strings, and they are tuned in four, so it's a different instrumental family than the violin family. So they coexist. So if you thought I was just a cellist playing another cello, it's very different. The tuning is different, and you can see that the frets. It's not like the viol player don't know how to play in tune, but the frets, because it facilitates them to play a lot of chords playing. In fact, the viol family is close to the guitar family or the lutes family, if you have seen the lutes, or even the big long roots, looks like it's called a fiogo. One day you can look at that. And the bridge is a little flat so that it's easier to cross strings, but it's also easier to hit the wrong string as well. So. And when Gregory, my violinist, he will talk more about, I'm sure, Baroque violin, which we all share the gut strings, different kinds of strings that modern strings, steel strings, it's a little different. And the bow that we use is different from the modern bow. Viol is particularly different because they use underhand bow, and you see the difference when the violin plays is on this way. It's kind of used in my as a bow. But viol is also known as a corn sword instrument. That means different sizes of viol play together in harmony, really matches each other. So if you have played a recorder before, many of you, there's a recorder consort when you have different sizes of recorder, treble, you know, soprano, alto, tenor, recorder play together. And if I have a viol, for example, and add up with a recorder, sometimes we can call it a broken consort because it's not the same type of instrument. Anyway, I would actually add one thing that's not on the program. I'm going to play a little Flow My Tears by John Dowland and on this treble viol, short version of it, and then we'll have the Ortiz pieces, which is really wonderful, short pieces with different characters. You can see that from programming, well, it's kind of dark, but you can see that in intonation, enjoy the different virtuosity and express series of all those pieces. So here is a little bit of the treble viol, how it sounds like.
Thank you. a sonata by an early Italian composer, Biagio Marini. He's born in the late 1590s in a town in northern Italy called Brescia. That's where the first violins came from too, which were invented in the very early part of the 16th century, the first decade. But it took about 100 years for them to catch on. People thought they were evil and the devil and lowly, not compared at all to the great viol concert, the viol instruments, the case of viols, the treble, the bass, the contrabass. Those are the instruments of choice at court. The violin gained its prominence with the birth of opera around 1600. So it was there to emulate the quality of the voice, the sustained singing, the dramatic quality. And Marini was one of the first composers to really start writing for the violin, expanded the technique of the instrument. He used lots of double stopping, playing in high positions, mistuning the strings to create new sounds and chords. So it's very innovative. This sonata that I'm about to play is from a collection of 60 sonatas they wrote in 1600.